Welcome back! The Seven Sages are causing trouble in each of the nations, so let's start in Planeptune with some chirpers. This is the first arcade I made when I became a CPU. Oh, the Colosseum. That would have been useful quite a while ago so I could get the skills up in the challenges, but I've got it now, so it's fine. And there we go, another chirper. I'm just reclusive, that's all. I'm scared to go outside. You'll get stronger with this. What is it? Add break combo slot. It's not great. I want the rush one. Right, so. Nep station. Nep. Go on then. It takes them ages to actually respond. It's really odd. Phew, things finally settled down. No, they didn't. What? What are you on about? What? Today's news will be presented by me, Blon, and that, the only CPU in the world bursting with maternal love. Hey, are you still going to make jokes about those things? You are reading into it too deep. I so wish to be doing this bit with Nepgear. That's my line. Whenever I have to do things with you, lots of things are... Please finish that thought. No, forget it. Let's read the news. First off, the Leanbox invasion. Greenheart, the CPU of Leanbox, led an attack against the other nations recently. Her audacious declaration of war ignited a battle for the world shares between all four nations. To those who had been waiting for my appearance, thank you for your patience. However, one must remember that a true protagonist shows up last. Big words from someone who got her ass handed to her. It is also a true protagonist's fate to suffer obstacles and taste a frustrating defeat. Just you watch. The people of this world will soon worship me, and me alone. I look forward to that event. Our next headline is meant to inform viewers that a new CPU has been born in Planeptune. Well, more like Neptune's real younger sister Nepgear fell here from another dimension. She awakened to her CPU form via CPU memory, making her the third CPU of Planeptune. Just a moment, the report is inaccurate. Nepgear became my little sister, therefore Leanbox now has two CPUs. You're the only one making that claim. Not true, Nepgear and I share a bond thicker than blood. So she claims. Viewers, you are three to decide what to think about the thing she says. I'll read the final headline. I have been waiting for this. Now then. Ooh, what's going on there? Oh, it's Kampa. Oh, what's going on with Blan? Blan goes nuts. Oh dear. In Planeptune's Basilicum, the children all had health inspections, including body measurements. Don't tell me. Us girls have to determine the measurements of these young ones. Children certainly grow fast. Yeah. It was a tranquil event, devoid of inappropriateness, although Blan erupted in a fury at one point. You were quick to flee after that painful display, weren't you? I believe it was when Kamba's chest measurements were taken, no? Oh, well, at the time, I just got really sick, so... Did she pass you already? Like hell she has! It's just barely, but I'm still... Wait, no. I see. Well, our time is now up. We look forward to seeing you again. Don't end the show with that. People will get the wrong idea. Hey! Oh dear, Blon. Nep station again. Do-do-doom. Do-do-doom. Do-do-doom-doom. I don't think you can do a dramatic reading of the music. It's here again, the coolest mail order showing program, yep. Shopping program ever. What a cushion nep. With our exhilarating lineup, you'll be on the road to bankruptcy in no time flat. Today's delectable treat is... Ta-da! Blan Manju! Knowing this, you can probably figure out who our guest will be. Yes! It's Blan! Hello! Well then, Blan, get to tell us what makes these Manju so special. Our Manju embody the culmination of Louise confectionery engineering. They are simple, but only the best ingredients are used. Secrets of a million flavors are sealed within. When you eat it, your HP will be restored, and you'll also get a nice boost to your tech stat. but the primary charming point of these is the imprint of me on each and every delicious treat. Oh, that's true. Your face is stamped on here like it's a sugary Louis currency. When you eat one, don't forget to think about how grateful you are to me for creating it. This squishiness is not Eureka! Ahaha! When I poke it hard, it totally smushes your face. This is what laughs are made of. I don't care if an imprinted face of mine gets smushed. No, this is like a theater of masterpieces. Look at it. What? The red bean paste is squirting out of my imprinted nose. Such accuracy. What are you doing? Hurry up and eat it. Or at least wipe it off. Ha ha ha, pervy blondes, pervy nosebleed. This is too much. Ha ha ha, can't do the laugh. I gotta show everyone. What? Wait. Yo, Noire, where you at? Boost your mobile signal and check out this hilarity. Except, wait, damn it, wait. Do I even have the money? I don't know. No, I don't. All right. Not that we're missing much there. Nep station again. Million up quiz. Welcome to the quiz show where everyone wins. Let's start. I took a nap today, so no more heavy eyelids for me. You're still you, Plutia. So when you can't know how long you'll hold out. So what? So we can't know how long you'll hold out. So let's blow through these. Woohoo! Question one of the following: whose personality barely changes when in HDD form? Well, it's Neptune most definitely changes. Blonde gets a bit more aggressive, but Nepgear, her tone of voice changes slightly. That's about it. Dingily-doo! Anti-seal receive. Second, what would you call Neptunia's position in the previous game, Neptunia Rebirth 2? Underling, of course, a minor role. Protagonist! Dingily-doo! Nepple SP received. Third, which customer complaint has not been levied against Leanbox? It's definitely too bulky, it's definitely got a giant power brick. It would have a warranty, so. Dingly doo! Antivirus received! That's it, folks. Folks. Wow, you made it to the end with energy to spare, Plutia. I've been napping since yesterday afternoon, so I could last all day today. Napping straight. I'm full of life. I have so many comments, but I'll save them until after the broadcast. See you next time, everyone! See you later. Bye-bye. Alright, information. Let's start with the little chirpers first. We've come to a fork in the road. The story won't change or whatever, so go wherever you want. Alright, fair enough. Nepgear! Three different incidents and three different nations all at once. It'll be four, they just don't know yet. This must be the work of the seven sages. Well, of course, come! I want to play with Nep-Nep. It's not fair that PP gets to have all the fun. Histoire! Lately, IF and Pichy's pranks have become so dangerous. The only one who does not do such things is Compa. Yes, Compa's a good girl. Right, let's start from the bottom here then. Beep! I've been to various countries. This is the place where I feel most at home. Bemitsu! Hey, do you want gang guides? I got you covered. The way will open when you look into an ancient lost nation. Oh, how very cryptic. Well, not really cryptic, is it? It's more straight to the point. Anyway, when I turn the camera on Verd, she strikes a ton of poses. In fact, she strikes too many. It's kind of irritating. Basilicum staff. I definitely don't want kids. Well, I don't want to work any more than what I get paid to do. Alright, fair enough. Miss Manual! Doing quests? It's fine if you're not, but if you do, you get rare items and plans. So stop being lazy and start doing some quests! Who said I was lazy? How dare you? Dangly! Recently, I picked up summoning. I can summon a cute spirit. I haven't mastered it yet, so it vanishes after a few seconds. Oh dear. Right, we'll start with mages. We'll make our way up the list. A lot of dots. To stare at one's face for such an interminable amount of time. What is your business, CPU candidate? Oh, I'm sorry, I have a friend that feels very similar to you, Magus, so... I understand. You're thinking of 5BB, correct? Huh? Magus, are you acquainted with 5BB? More than mere acquaintances, we are in fact relatives. 5BB is one of my friends who fought with us to save game industry from the deity of sin and R4. What do you mean, and? I thought they were the same thing. She was just a singer in Lean Box, but ever since we defeated the deity of sin, she's exploded in popularity. Now she's game industry's biggest star, going on world tours, huge record sales, she even has her own energy drink now. To think that 5BB had a relative, and even if it's a coincidence, to run into her in this world. Nepgear, are you in good spirits? What could be spacing you out like that? Could it be? Is this the organization transmitting strange radio waves and attempting to brainwash you? Oh, no, I'm sorry. We were talking about you and 5PB being related, yes? Correct. As evidence here, she and I have the same mole, do we not? No, I don't think mole position and being related have anything to do with each other. Well, in my case, it is not in actuality a mole, but an imprint of sin. Huh? It's not a mole? An imprint of sin? What happened in the past? When the appropriate time is nigh, I will release the information to you. More importantly, if you're related to 5PB, that means you came from the same world we did. Yes, because of your older sister, a magical science accident, and the door of Fatestone, I've been summoned here. I'm sorry, my sister has a charming tendency to cause such trouble. Because of this, I've made unexpected progress in dimensional travel research. It's no bother, I wish to thank her. Dimensional travel? Is something like that possible? Nepgear, have you so quickly forgotten? You too have crossed dimensions. Oh yeah, that's right. Well, it's usually impossible. However, it is made possible with science spells that I, the mad magician, have fused. You're a magician, right, Majors? Are you also knowledgeable in science? Yes, I am particular, even. To mechanical engineering as well. Aside from magic research, I have a variety of inventions. In fact, the headphones that 5PB is using is something I've crafted for her personally. I'm quite proud of them. What? Is that true? I have always been supporting her from the shadows in my own way, so she may succeed as an idol. Now then, our conversation has drifted. As stated before, I have within my inventions something like this. A ray gun? This is my hyperdimension gadget number one, gun particle cannon. If you point this at the TV, then pull the trigger. Wow, the TV turned on. Is it not magnificent? You may turn on the TV or change the channels, as if you are shooting a gun. It's amazing. Not only is it significantly more ergonomic due to its gun-like shape, but you can also yell, "Take this," or "Careless," when choosing a program like the protagonist of a robot anime. It's an amazing invention, Magus. It's almost like you put the romance of robots into a single form. You are one to understand well. Oh, but if it were me, I'd make it so you could replace the remote part. Like the energy pack of a beam rifle. When it's charged, it could interact with various TVs, recorders, gaming consoles. An interesting idea. If treated properly, it would be like an exchange system. How superb! Ah, a revelation. How would you feel if this remote's energy was supplied by external microwaves? By eliminating the battery, it would become more lightweight, increasing its efficiency tenfold. That's really good. Oh, but then we would need a microwave transmission device to see if that could work. This is not a problem. The ceiling in this room bears a perfectly sized light hanging right there. Let us reconfigure that light to be a microwave transmission device. But if we did that, we may need a person to activate the device. You are right. It would be a pain to constantly stand to activate it. It's out of the question to build a remote to turn on the device to... Oh! What is it? Have you too had a revelation? Why don't we have Histoire activated? She has a transceiver function, and she's always in the Basilicum, so I think she'd be perfect. True, she may just be the... She may just be suitable for the task. Then, what of the shout? I feel as though take this or careless is too simple. We have to think bigger, more grand. Maybe even a classic gun particle cannon fire. How about yelling an exaggerated, I won't let the world be destroyed? Yes, that is completely feasible, Nepgear. It looks as if we may get along quite well. If you'd like, would you care to help me with my research? I feel as though I could walk the path of madness with you. Okay, I'll help with your research, Magus, and I'd be proud to walk the path of madness alongside you. Nepgear has mastered the Scientist of Madness ability. What? I got another weird ability? But I might be happy about this one. The system is blessing you, it seems. We are comrades now, friends. I look forward to working with you. I look forward to it as well, Magus. Well, that was good, wasn't it? Now, what have we got here? Oh, of course. Need to go back out, back in. Alright, oh, Magus again. You know, it's been bothering me for a while, but the device you have is a mini comp, isn't it, Magus? It is, but what of it? That's so cool, back in our world, it's rare because of how fast it got popular. I wasn't able to buy one. It's amazing that you have one. 5EB had composed the jingle for the Minicom, and she received quite a few, and so gave one to me. For 5PB? That's amazing! I wonder if the signal would reach even this world. It has not been announced yet. I thought it alright to tell you, but it is a secret, so please. Still a secret, I see. I understand. By the way, what kind of apps do you have on it, Magus? Ah yes, I recently downloaded a fighting game app called Bear Fighter 2 Championship Edition. Oh, is that the one with Shodan? Shodan? I don't know. It's unexpected that you're into fighting games. I wouldn't have guessed. It is not that I am into fighting... What? What am I reading right now? It is not that I am a fighting games player. It's that these bears are suited in mech armor. I don't know what I'm reading anymore. It's that these bears are suited in mech armor. Amusing, yes? Also, it was cheap. I couldn't help it. What other apps do you have? What I have installed now is a map app, along with mail, phone, and the chirper. Also, the reality extension app. Oh, you actually have a lot of normal apps. I've only just obtained it, after all. From now on, I will download many apps and gradually dye it my own color. By the way, what is that reality extension app? It is an app where you use the Minicom to extend the environment which people perceive. By staring? By starting the app and looking through the Minicom's cam, you add or delete info from the surrounding environment. It would be faster to show you than explain. Look at me through the Minicom. What is this? Some text appeared. So, you can get info on both me and my surroundings, yes? You can check geotags in this way. It is through the monitor. But there is a function to change a subject's clothing as well. But the thing to focus on rather than such a function is the geotags. Clothing, is this it? By applying geotags, it is possible to leave messages in the world seen through the camera. Oh, quite a bit of outfits. I think this would look good on Magus. Nepgear, stop speaking to yourself and listen seriously to my... There. It suits her in a way, doesn't it? I like it. Wow, Magus' clothing changed! You aren't possibly using that app to change my clothes, are you? Wow, Magus, you look really cute! What? Hey, what are you putting on me? You aren't making me wear anything strange, are you? Your usual clothes are nice, but these clothes fit you pretty well too. I know, I'll stylize with some super trendy accessories. Hey, do not proceed further. I am not the type to dress up and be admired. I think Kai's would look good on you too. Hey, did you hear me? I just said. Let me try there. Wow, you really are cute. It's so easy to look fashionable with this, and it's convenient to take pictures. Hey, are you done? I'm not used to being so fixated upon. Oh, I'm sorry. I kind of got carried away. Do not worry. I was the same the first time as well. Now that I've just touched the minicom, I want it even more. I've wondered, but could you not obtain it through CPU authority? It seems like Neptune is doing that once in a while, but for me, it's not fair, so I don't like it. It's definitely better to have pre-ordered competitions or line up all night for these sort of new devices. It's my dream to be interviewed on TV while standing in a big line outside Better Buy and say, "The hype is real." I see. I do not quite understand the terminology, but please do your best. Indeed. Right, back we go. Mages again? I failed. Oh, don't remind me of that. Why would you remind me? Remind me of that game. That was such a heartbreaking scene. I'm not reading it out. I'm just not. Mages, what's wrong? You've been mumbling for a while now. I failed slightly during my research. What research were you doing? I remodeled this microwave to be controlled remotely by a mobile phone. But when I attempted to heat some fried chicken, for some reason it froze. Odd that. What? It froze when you tried heating it up? Next when I tried a banana. Wait, just a second. What is it? Bananas aren't things to be heated, right? I heard it. The voice of a mad scientist telling me to place the banana in the microwave. So when I tried to heat a banana in the microwave, yes, it turned into that green gelatinous banana you see there. What? This is a banana? Will you try eating it? Alright, left, I want to try eating it. Right, no, I think I'll pass. What the goodness? What was that? My line was kind of weird. It is time to choose, so which is it? The Noire. I see, so that is your decision. Why do you look so disappointed? Never mind. That said, this is interesting research material. Nepgear, I will try to get inside the microwave, so could you press the button for me? If you do that, you'll die, Mages. Besides, it's a physical impossibility. I changed the words. I see, a shame. Then I must test something else. Please do that from the beginning. Then, fried chicken again. Now, could you see what has happened this time, Nepgear? Nepgear? She's not here. Where has she gone? Oh well, more importantly, the chicken. It is most certainly frozen. Why? What is this? Mages, you look so serious. What's wrong? Nepgear, where had you gone? Report to me whenever you wish to leave the room in the middle of an experiment. Anyway, look. It's frozen chicken, yes. What's wrong with it? What's wrong? You do not remember? Did we ever talk about something like this, Mages? You had just been here talking to me about it, had you not? Have you forgotten? I just walked into this room for the first time now. Something is strange. What time is it? The first time I heated the chicken was 12:05. I should have heated the banana about 5 minutes later. But the time has not even reached 12:10 yet. By chance, this could be movement through time. If that is the case, if I combine magic with this scientific phenomena, I may be able to travel between dimensions. First, I must clarify the theory of time travel, then incorporate it. Incorporate my spells, mumble. So strange, Mages. Hey, can you heat up that chicken? I'm getting hungry. Who knows what will happen because of that? I might end up with some weird new divergence. Broccoli! This is random, but do you have any kinds of special skills, Broccoli? Oh yes, new. I can shoot laser beams new from my eyes. Goodness, really? Nepgear, your eyes, they're sparkling new. Is that healthy? Perhaps it's something like beams from original Super Monster Something Z? I don't get the example. I'll just shoot it, New. Can you show me? Just once is fine, pretty please. Pretty well, New. Just one time, New. Yay, this is so exciting. Thump thump. Thump thump. Makara beam, New. Oh, her eyes melted again. There's some weird jelly-type liquid oozing out of her eyes. Oh no, that mysterious gel's getting all over the floor. His father's gonna be so mad. I messed up, New. When you mess up, gel comes out of your eyes? Sometimes smoke and water come out too. It's a pretty deep purple too, New. Do you want me to try until I'm successful, New? I don't know. Is your success rate pretty high? It's about half, New. Half, then it's either I succeed or I fail, New. What? That's what you mean by half? Which is higher, percentage-wise? Failure is overwhelmingly higher, New. Then it's alright, I'm fine. Really, New? I could try once more time. Once more? One more. No, really, it's fine. Thanks, though. I want to see it, but if the floor gets any dirtier, this'll be a disaster. Broccoli Land Makara Bean? Alright, back in. Marvy! My name is Nep Clap Clap. My name is Toon Clap Clap. My name is Nep Neptune Toon. Neptune, why are you singing? Marvy was in a musical long ago, and a rerun just aired on TV. We were watching it earlier. My sister's always been easily influenced by things she sees on TV. You cannot beat her. Musical theatre. Duet time! Noire, let's rock! La di da di da di da di da di da. Something like that, anyway. Okay, stop. It's annoying now. It sounds lively in here. What's going on, ladies? Neptune watched the musical you were in, and it hasn't shut up since. Well, sure, I can understand that. That's actually how I got into musicals in the first place. You too, Marvy? I got into it after working as an actress's bodyguard long ago. I even suggested that my academy should put on musicals as part of more entertaining missions. And it was your assignment. The fact that you got to see a live musical makes me jealous. You've never seen one live, Noire? I'd like to at least once, but I never bothered because it would be weird to go alone. Besides, ever since I became a CPU, I've been busy, so... Oh man, I feel that. On those rare days off, you just want to rest your bones after all that hard work. Nepgear, is she telling a joke? I wonder. You should all come to see my Academy's musical. It's based on games and anime made for today's youth, so it's pretty simplistic. I think we're putting on a show in Planeptune next week, so I'll get you all some Primo tickets. Really? Yes! Are you sure? Those are expensive, aren't they? Don't worry, as long as you all have fun, I'll be happy. Oh, alright then. Will we ever get to see this musical? Maybe. Marvy, how can I get boobies like you? Ask all you want, but I'm not sure how mine got this big either. I've heard that if you drink lots of milk, they'll get big and strong or something. Or maybe in my case, it's because I eat my delicious futomaki every day that they got this large. I'll eat futomaki and get big too. It's only natural that I grow up and get a hot bombshell body that puts Nep to shame. I'm just... sorry. Hey, what's that supposed to mean? Neppy, Is the IF from your world concerned about her appearance? Unfortunately for the world, she's got about the same dimensions as me. Why? When I transform, I'm all like, boobs ahoy! Oh, I shouted that out really loud again. So I don't really have a problem with it. I really do wonder what the neighbors think. They hear me yelling out stuff like tits, boobs, and all sorts of things. Oh dear, oh dear. You suck, Nep. Boom. I'm gonna become a CPU too. Even if you do, there's no guarantee your boobs will get any bigger. The ultimate example of such a sad phenomena is our dear Blonde. Whoa, if Lady Blonde heard that, I don't think any of us would still have our heads attached. Indeed. Right, so let's see here. Tekken! Well, I finished my shopping, so I'm gonna go head back to the Basilicum. Yo, Noir, before we go back to the BCOM, alright, do you want to go play at an arcade for a little bit? Look here, Neptune, it's not the time to run off in game. You're a CPU too, so why don't you just act like one? Someone help me! What? That voice, Noir! Yeah, it's Tekken, I recognize it anywhere. Let's hurry and see. Tekken, what's wrong? Are you okay? Lady Noir!
Lady Noir is scary.
Tekken, are you okay? What happened?
I was playing a fighting game at the arcade when a bunch of guys started yelling at me. And then they chased me around. It was sex. It was scary.
I bet they were just mad because they lost to a girl. Men are the worst. Alright, jeez, Noir, thanks. Where'd those fools run off to? In the name of the moon, I will punish you. I mean, them, but whatever.
They're over there, in that back alley.
Huh? This squad's been R-E-K-T, wrecked. And the ground walls are broken. What happened here? Tekken happened here. It's like a heap of corpses. Well, they deserved it for what they did, so who cares?
Oh, men are scary. Are you sure they won't get up again?
Tekken, were you the one who bashed up all these pea brains?
Yeah, I think so. They chased me so they could bully me, but I resisted a little.
You think so? A little?
Eek, Lady Noir, that guy's finger twitched just now. It twitched. Oh, so scary.
Oh, she doesn't remember a thing. She's like a werewolf. Hey, Mrs. T. Don't let me go to arcades with you, okay? Yes, it could be quite dangerous. Right, so let's see, Tekken again! We've got a lot to go through, haven't we?
Nepgear, a minute please.
Sure thing, Tekken. Is something the matter? I have an odd request, but would you help me with my training?
And as a warning, it's tiring and it'll hurt sometimes, so you don't have to if you don't want to.
Oh, Tekken, I'd love to help you get stronger. We're friends too, so you don't have to hold back.
Really?
Yep, let's train together.
What kind of training will it be?
It's sparring. I'd like you to put these gloves on and catch my punches and kicks.
Oh, well, on second thought, do you think I can really take your punches, Tekken?
It's fine, it's fine. I'll go easy, so don't worry. Okay, here I go.
Yeah.
Phew, I guess this will do for today. Thank you, Nepgear. You really helped.
It's finally over. Even though I was wearing gloves, my arms are throbbing.
I know. Do you want to try punching at me this time, Nepgear?
Huh? Me?
Yep, it's boring to just take punches. So why don't you try? It's fun. It might even relieve some stress.
Okay, maybe. I'll try it out for a little bit.
That's the spirit. You don't need to hold back either. Hit me as hard as you want to.
Is that really okay, hitting you as hard as I can? What if I miss?
Don't worry about me, I spar like this all the time.
You understand then, exhales. Here I come, gear knuckle.
Rock.
Tekken, are you okay?
I'm okay, just hit me right in the solar plexus, a little harder than I was expecting.
Why can we see her underwear?
Why? It makes no sense. Bizarre.
Oh no, you're turning kind of pale. Maybe it's best we rest a little while.
Okay, just continue.
But Tekken, come on, you look like you're in a lot of pain. We can't continue training like this.
Please, Nepgear, please don't stop. It hurts, but this pain feels so good.
I don't know where I got so from, but alright.
What? That's why I think if I keep getting hit by you, I'll feel even better.
Please, Nepgear, keep going. Don't stop.
I don't think I'm really into that sort of thing, so...
No way. Even if I ask this much?
Please ask Plutia for that kind of...
I want it to be you, Nepgear. Are your eyes welling up? Oh goodness, Tekken, please don't look up at me with those eyes. You're so mean, Nepgear. I can't even believe you. What just happened?
Oh dear, we never find out what happened because of that. Alright, fair enough. CyberConnect 2!
You came from Fukuoka, right, Cybercon? What kind of place is Fukuoka? Kind of place? I guess it's a place that has lots of delicious food, probably even better than what's in Planeptune. Our ramen with firm, thin noodles and rich, delicious, savory pork soup is pretty famous. Red ginger and sesame seeds are perfect with the noodles and soup, so I love eating those as toppings. Gulp. Spicy mustard Re is also famous and is the poster child of Fukuoka's production.
Produce, even.
That faint spice pairs well with white rice. You're on your third bowl before you know what hit you. And there's more. Hot pot dishes called Mizutaki or Matsunabe. Also, you can't forget Okuto and Abutikamo. Them? What are those mysterious sounding foos? That is a local dish that's been passed down from generation to generation for hundreds of years. It takes seaweed called, that's boiled, drained, and hardened. Then they cut it into strips. Then dipped in ponzu or sesame oil. Sesame oil? Just thinking about it makes me hungry. Any breakfast is incomplete without it. That is a dish where you grill pearl spot chromis fish? Oh no. The fish is delicious when roasted and chopped on. And chomped on. Not chopped on. Chomped on. Dear oh dear. So that's how it got that name. Just listening to you talk about it is making me drool. That sounds so tasty. I'd really like to try some. Once things have calmed down, you should come visit Fukuoka. I'll treat you to a whole bunch of Fukuoka's speciality dishes. Really? Oh golly wow! Thank you so much. You can thank me after you try it. Does Planeptune have any culinary specialities? I've just come to Planeptune, so I don't know anything. Anything at all, Nepgear? Well, actually, Planeptune doesn't really have dishes that can be called specialities. Our CPUs are Plutia, patron goddess of naps, and my sister, who never really likes to work very hard. I hadn't considered that, yeah. With those CPUs, I guess I could believe it. I really do want to treat you to Planeptune speciality dishes, Cybercon, but you don't have to get depressed, Nepgear. Look on the bright side. You could make one for your nation. Huh? Me? That's right! But can I really do it? It'd be my first time trying something just out of a dream like that. There's a first time for everything. Besides, everybody's got to be doing something. Why not cook? You know, dreams are there to be realized. Why can't you be the one to make Planeptune's speciality? I think you could do it, Nepgear. Cybercon, I understand. In the place of Neptune, no. I, Nepgear, will show you that I can make Planeptune's speciality dish. When Planeptune finally has a speciality, I want you to be the first to try it. So please wait until then, Cybercon. Yeah, of course, I'm looking forward to it. Who knows what it'll be? I thought pudding was the speciality. Alright. Today, there's a special someone I want to introduce you to, Neptunia. A special someone? To introduce to me? What does this mean? Who is it? You'll see soon enough. Now then, today's special guest, come on in. Hi, so you're Neptune's younger sister, Nepgear, huh? Huh, you really are quite similar. You must be the person Neptune was telling me about. Huh, I feel like I've seen her before. Yep, hi Nepgear, I'm Falcom. I'm a newbie adventurer, and it's real nice to meet you. Oh, hello, it's nice to meet you. Wait, what? Ever since I heard from Neptune that you're good friends with the Otherworld's me, I've been waiting to meet you. Neptune, is this person Falcom? Oh yes, behold the Falcom from a galaxy kind of far away. Well, you're surprised, aren't you? Neptune, surprised hardly covers it.
She's completely different from the Falcom I know, and smaller. This is crazy. Neptune was saying it too, but am I really that different from the other me? Well, you are similar in a way, but the other Falcom is older. The other me is older, huh? Eh, don't worry about it, I'm sure you get older through the game. Won't you? Yeah. Because that would make sense, seeing as time progresses faster here. So she's obviously going to get older through the rest of the game. Right? Oh, that's right. I wanted to ask, but is the other world's me stylish? Well, what do you mean by that exactly? Oh no, it's not a deep question or anything. It's just, I was kind of wondering how it would grow up to be in the future and stuff. Don't worry, she's a very stylish and super cool woman. That's good. I'm a little reassured. And she's not just stylish, but she's a world-famous adventurer. Everyone knows who she is. Her own adventure story was made into a book called Rage Brigade. It's a bestseller worldwide. Won awards too. The other me is amazing, huh? Even if it's another world's me, I can't lose as a fellow adventurer. Hey Nepgear, could you tell me more about the other world's me? Sure. Then why don't we take our time talking while eating snacks? I've just received some delicious tea leaves and cookies. Yeah, I'll have some. I'm gonna go prepare it. Please sit tight. The other world's me, huh? What kind of person she is? I don't want to meet her. Alright, so back out and back in cave. Yay, it's cave! Nepgear, you are in this dimension as well, I see. Yes, thanks to a little accident. Accident? You ran into the portal thing. I wouldn't have expected you to be here as well, Cave. Well, I know it's kind of sudden, but can you tell us how things are in our dimension? I've been worried sick about it ever since I left. A simple request to fulfill. Before I came here, I was with Rom and Ram. We were all searching for 5PB, who had gotten missing. Fifi B isn't here either. I don't know where she went. Maybe that dummy disappeared. I mean, we've looked forever and we haven't found a single clue. She disappeared? You think it really happened? No, I don't. Her idle presence was doing well, and she was taking ample time off. Disappearing would be senseless. Can we take a break too? Maybe we can eat a snack and it'll make us happier. I love that idea, Ram. I'm gonna buy a bucket of ice cream from that shop over there. Whee! For you, Cave. I appreciate it. Look, look. Hehe, sweet and delicious. Miss Cave, you laughed. You looked so anxious and stuff for a long time. I was worried. Yeah, watching you be a nervous wreck was making us kinda nuts, too. But if you can eat sweets and laugh, I guess you're fine. You too. Thank you very much. I better be rad to see Cave smile even more. So let's go buy some awesome crepes over there. Eclair, please. Relax, the shops will not vanish just because they are off screen. Let us enjoy our crepes together. Cave? Yes? It was a good story at first, but it ended up about you and the twins going around eating sweets. Ah. Oh, is that it? Do we not know what happened with 5PB? Alright. Bishi! Ah, Neptunia! Hey, wait. Yo, why are you crying, Pico? What's going on? Did Iffy say something mean? No, I didn't. She was running around inside and smacked her face into the wall. Oh, I see. You poor thing. That must have hurt, huh? What a little idiot. But wait, Pico, you don't normally cry from something like that. Doesn't hurt, but I'm scared. Scared? Well, Pishi's face got all red and Compass said she'd fix her up. Oh. P, don't run away from me. No, I don't want a shot. Goodness, Compass, are you running around with that giant syringe again? Oh, so you're scared of shots. I see. For most kiddos, the three biggest fears are shots, ghosts, and eggplants. Eggplants? Why not bell peppers? Eggplants are the devil's fruit. Please give me your face.
If I give you a shot where you hit your head, you'll feel all better. No, not my face!
Compa can say the most terrifying things with the straightest face.
Don't make her cry too much. Please. I'm gonna have to confiscate your syringe too. Aw, why?
You're too young to be handling large pointy objects, Compa.
Yep, when you're older, you can fling it around all you like. I mean, you do in my dimension, so. Golly, I don't get it, but I guess I'll wait.
Compa syringe received. That's one of the first items we need in order to head towards the good and true ending, but I've got a plan with this, don't worry. Because we will be doing the normal ending, obviously. Bishi!
Neptunia, let's play!
That's it? Alright, I have.
Okay, so in this part, you'll learn where the dark light is kept, and I don't get it, but that sounds really cool.
I know, right? You understand my thought process pretty well, Bishi.
Huh? How rare to see Bishi playing with nary a scream. What are you doing? Drawing?
Drawing? Get real. Don't compare what I'm doing with that kiddie stuff.
Really? I thought you were drawing something quite imaginative. It's like, yeah. We're making up a story.
A story?
That's...
Whoa, all fear the mighty Iffy. Have you already awoken to your dark, infinite powers?
If you're that curious about it, I could show you some of it.
Yeah, let me see all of it.
But if she doesn't grow out of this kind of thinking, maybe we should stop her now.
Don't be a party pooper, Nep Jr. This is totally hilarious.
I refuse to stop a child from using her power of imagination.
What she said. Besides, they're playing together so nice.
But...
Oh, what's that? Why is that person's right hand glowing in a neon poster? Like a neon poster.
Good eyes, Nep. The hand holds the power of another Gaia inside it.
It's sweet! Whenever that hand grabs... Whatever that hand grabs goes kablooey!
Because it's so powerful, she can only use it 3 times, of course. Otherwise, it'll eviscerate her instead.
Wow, Iffy. You know such big words.
Haha, pure gold! So pure that it hurts my funny bone.
Okay, tell me about the feather next.
Just one feather?
That's not a feather, it's a wing.
She angered Metatron, so the rest of it got ripped off.
Yeah, we decided she'd attach a bug's wing in its place.
It's not a bug. We're talking about the Lord of Flies, Beelzebub.
Beelzebub,
awesome. Next up, the Demon of Gluttony.
Wow, you're oddly knowledgeable about this sort of thing, Nep.
So anyway, this one here is...
I want to know more too.
Look it, this is a cross by B.
They're having fun, so I guess it's okay.
I just hope this won't be an embarrassing memory for IF later.
Why not?
What? Why would it be?
What?
That makes no sense. IF!
Pishi, I'll give you special training so you can beat Nep. Just give me time to think up a hellish training course.
Oh dear. Alright, so that's us done in Planeptune, I guess. So, that's us done for this part. In the next part, we'll head off to the Wii!
Histoire, I'm getting sleepy.
Alright, she's getting sleepy. I assume that was little IF rather than big IF, because it would be weird for big IF to say that. Anyway, next part, we'll head off to Louis. So we'll see you then. Bye-bye for now.